everyone, and welcome back to another episode of the Triton Talk. My name is Lila, and today I am joined by Brooks Jordan of the sailing team. Hi, Brooks. How are you?
Doing good. How are you?
Well, I'm doing great. Beautiful day today.
I know.
So I heard that you are very involved on campus and that you're part of the emergency response team. Wow. And how did you get involved in that, and what has your experience been like?
Well, I got involved because prior to coming to Eckerd, I'm already an EMT, and I was with my EMT group back at home for a while. And then coming to campus, I heard that they have a response group here, so I was like, oh, perfect way to just like continue what I was already doing. So I came to campus, and then I heard that during like through the club fairs that they're having a little like recruitment session. So I went through the recruitment phase. I passed, and then I passed all my like probationary sort of things I got to do. And now I'm kind of like a fully fledged member getting involved, and it's been really rewarding. It's been really different working as college EMS, but I think it's so much more personal, and it just kind of shows how much like you give, you truly care that you do give.
Yeah, and it's not an easy job. I've seen you guys.
Especially scheduling.
Yes. Is this something you want to do for a career?
I definitely think so. Obviously, you know, I still doing all my classes, trying to figure out what I really want to do. But I'm on the pre-med, pre-PA track right now. So I've been doing all that, and I really think I want to continue this after college.
That's awesome. Well, thank you for everything you do.
No worries. Well, thank you.
Yeah. Switching gears a little bit, you're also a member of the conference's TIDE Task Force, which was formed this year. Can you talk about your work with TIDE?
Sure. Well, for TIDE, that we work in general to make sailing a more inclusive and better experience for a lot of people, for people who are part of different groups that aren't really represented in sailing. But in my group, my work in particular is I'm with the social media and outreach side of TIDE. So what we do is obviously we do a big presence on social media, on Instagram and Facebook. And then I also try to help coordinate things that sailors in college can get involved with outside of their college sailing. So whether that be high school sailing groups for different types of people organizations, such as there's a sort of like a wounded veteran sailing club that we are trying to incorporate, and just trying to get the word out and have people come to our sport more.
Yeah, and what is your newest project with that? Do you have one?
Yeah, so our newest project is we're getting resources sheets out for everyone, for sailors and coaches and athletic departments, for everyone who's in our SAISA TIDE conference. And basically that would be it's not just for different, you know, groups of people, but it's also for sailors in general, like a resource of who they can reach out to if they're having issues, awareness campaigns that we're also doing, and then just making our information and bringing presence of who we are more.
Well, that's awesome. Thank you so much for that. So switching gears again, I'm told that you're a huge fan of Serena Williams. Can you talk about why she inspires you?
Oh, yeah. I think, first of all, she's a phenomenal athlete. At age 39, she has 23 Grand Slam titles, and she's still going.
Yeah.
I think, obviously, she has so much skill and just a lot of experience in tennis, but she's breaking so many boundaries, not only like socially within the tennis community and the Netflix in a whole, but I think she's also just goes to show that, you know, no matter your age or no matter, you know, where you come from, your background, whoever you are, that if you put in the work and you put in the effort, you can achieve anything. One of the things that she says, I always remind myself, is that, you know, no matter how old you are, like you can, if you put your mind to it, like you can do anything.
Yeah,
that's a cheesy saying, but
no, but that's true. And she's also a mother now, so she's broken another boundary. Yeah. And then finally, what is your favorite thing about Eckerd?
My favorite thing about Eckerd would probably be how individual Eckerd is and how much individual attention that you can get. Obviously with resources of like, you know, but of like having people work with you like in the classroom and all that, but also having a close-knit community that I know I can rely on is pretty good. I know I can rely on my teammates. I know that I could, you know, text my coach or walk up to my coach and have a conversation about her or tell her about something's going on, and also how the professors and all of them, they're really inviting in their activities and their projects, and they want to get you involved, and it's so easy to make an Eckerd experience so personal to you.
Yeah, for sure. I agree with everything you said. Thank you so much for joining.
Yeah. Well, thank you for having me.
Yeah, of course. And we'll see you guys on the next episode of the Triton Talk. Stay tuned. Bye.
Go Tritons.